Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Today we're going to do a smoked chicken with two different types of rub on it. And we're going to start out by spatchcocking our chicken. Now, judging by the comments I got last time I showed you this technique, not many people do it this way. So I just follow along through the rib cage, just like that, and then down through the spine. And I cut the chicken in half. We'll deal with the leg half in a second. Then you can see there's just a little bit of the rib cage left here inside the chicken. And I just put the knife in like that and cut it out. And it comes out super simple. And then for the breastplate, I just score it a little bit. And then I turn it over and crack the breast. And so we're left with a breast half that lays flat, and also a dark meat half that still lays flat as well. And just a tiny little bit of backbone that's gonna go into a container in the freezer for stock. Now, judging by the comments, not too many people do it this way. The last time I did it, I had all kinds of people telling me that I was doing it wrong and that I didn't know what I was doing, and that's fine. I like doing it this way for a bunch of different reasons. It's fast. I watch people struggle with kitchen shears trying to cut the backbone out of a chicken. But I see people trying to cut out the backbone with a knife and they can't quite get it all the way through, and it just turns into this thing. This way is fast and simple. It also gives me two separate halves of the bird that is great when you're cooking it on a grill because they cook at different times. One takes longer than the other. And so you're able to move them around the grill so that they finish at the same time to bring them to the dinner table. And by leaving that little bit of backbone in the dark side, it's easier to move around the grill as well. So I'm just going to trim off a little bit of the skin here, and then we're going to put on a dry rub. And I'm going to use two different kinds of dry rub today. I'm going to use a Montreal steak spice rub on the dark meat and a rib rub on the white meat. Okay, so I have washed my hands, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep one clean hand for sprinkling on the spice mix. And I'm going to start on the inside of the chicken first and coat the whole thing. And then I'm going to let them sit for about 15 minutes so this sort of just dries onto the chicken before I turn it over and do the other side. So this one is the Montreal steak spice. Goes quite nice on dark meat chicken. And on the breast side, it is our rib rub. Of course, if you have a shaker, go ahead and use a shaker. That works great. Otherwise, sprinkle it on and don't actually rub it in. Just let it sit on top of the chicken. So the idea is that you want most of the rub to adhere to the chicken so that when you flip it over to put it on the other side, it doesn't all fall off. 10, 15 minutes should accomplish this. Sometimes it doesn't, sometimes it does. And I know a lot of people rub a little bit of oil on the outside to really stick that rub on. I didn't today for whatever reason, so I'm just going to give it a go. Again, clean hand, chicken hand, and I'm going to put these over onto a rack. Pretty good. And then sprinkle on the last of the rub. Then I'm going to stick these in the fridge for a couple hours while I do some other things and then get the smoker ready to go. Now, if you've been watching this channel since 2007, you'll know that early on, 2007, 2008, 2009, we did a lot of backyard barbecue stuff. In fact, we had a full-on backyard barbecue set with a couple of really cool smokers and barbecues. And it was too early for YouTube at that point. YouTube just wasn't ready to watch a lot of cooking shows. So we stopped and I got rid of all of that stuff. And I'm now just thinking I want to go back out and try it again and see what happens. So I'm in the process of rebuilding our backyard barbecue set. And I started out with the cheapest, absolute cheapest, gas smoker that I could find. In fact, the smoker cost less than the pellets that you put in it to make the smoke. So I'll introduce you to that when we get outside. So out here at the smoker, I'm going to use a combination of maple chips and hickory pellets. And once the temperature is stabilized and we've got some smoke, we'll put the chicken in. So, watch your eyes. Breast in first. And then the thighs, and I've put a temperature probe into the thighs so we can watch how it cooks. Okay, so this is where I give you the 30-second review of the Master Forge gas smoker. The least expensive gas smoker that I could find anywhere. Not much more than a bag of wood chips. So, why is it that cheap? It's not terribly well made. It is fairly thin metal. It's not in any way insulated. I've got it in the shade because I can control the heat better in the shade. I found that if I put it in the sun and a cloud goes by, the temperature drops and then the temperature goes skyrocketing again. So, is it a great smoker? No, but if you're just starting out and you're not sure if you want to smoke or how long you want to do it or if you're even going to like it, it's probably a pretty good entry level into the world of smoking. The grates aren't huge, you're not going to feed a whole lot of people with this, but if your family is maybe 4 or 5 people, it's going to be just fine. Temperature gauge isn't that great, so you should always have a separate temperature gauge. It's certainly not as good as a $2,000 smoker, but are you going to get smoked food out of it? Yes. Are you going to learn something? Yes. Is it going to cost you a lot of money? No. So, all in all, you get what you pay for. But in this case, it does the job. Okay, we have reached the right temperature. 160 degrees in the breast and about 175 in the thighs. So, pull this out, get rid of the temperature probe. And then we'll let this rest for 10 or 15 minutes to get some carryover cooking.
Hey friends, hey Glen, we are here, still eating potato salad.
Potato salad is really good, but we're here to talk about this chicken. So, I did 2 different rubs on the chicken and then smoked it.
Put down the potato salad.
And so, I think it turned out pretty well.
Looks good.
Yeah. Yeah, we got a really nice, good mahogany color on the skin, and the skin is pretty nice. So, let's take off a wing.
Your favorite part?
Oh, I love the wing. Yep. Didn't come off nicely. And we'll slice a little bit of the chicken breast. Okay, so the breast is done with our rib rub. There you go.
Thank
and
you.
The legs and thighs are done with Montreal steak rub. Montreal steak rub.
Okay. Oh, I'll leave that there for you.
Yep. Okay. So, the chicken is really moist and juicy. The breast meat. It's got great flavor.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Just enough smoke.
That's
not
really
too
nice.
Much. The rub
ready,
on the skin
friend.
Is really nice.
Oh. get slicing, I'm ready.
Julie wants the Montreal steak. Okay, mm-hmm. So. There we go. This will have a completely different flavor almost. I mean, this it'll mostly be the smoke, but
Mm-hmm. Different and yet the same.
Yeah. So
it's got some different highlights to it.
Yeah.
But it's generally very similar.
So because I used it in the same smoker with the same smoke, it's got that same smoke flavor, but where you get into the spice on the skin, it has a different flavor.
Mm-hmm.
I think this is amazing. So even with you know, a not so great smoker, you can still make some really good food. And this is just the beginning of our exploration of smoking this summer.
We're gonna be in trouble.
We're gonna do quite a bit of it.
It's gonna be a lot of eating to do.
So, thanks for stopping by. Stay safe. See you again soon.